When it comes to the NHS, don't whisper it, don't hold back, speak loud and proud about what we've done in office.
Mais c'est tellement nouvelle cette chanson.
La mer qu'on voit danser.
Accident and emergency departments across England are under pressure like never before.
Are you saying that the hospitals are literally, some of them, going to run out of money?
After 4 years of no growth in the budget, frankly, it's hard to see where the savings will come from.
You're a conservative, you can set out what you think it is and what you think needs to be done.
I personally think that the Chancellor's going to have to write a bigger cheque.
Impact is already being felt on patient care. I could go on, there are pressures in mental health services which haven't been well reported. Everywhere you look across the NHS, there are pressures facing patient care.
We're all in this together.
As the NHS is torn apart into pieces gobbled up by the privateers, it will disintegrate when we need ever closer integration. We will get less care for more money. There will be increasing rationing.
So I think we have great risks in irrational responses to genuine problems. I think that's our biggest risk.
I'm a general practitioner and directly related. It is inconceivable that the 7-day rollout that you're proposing is, it's just not viable. I'm sorry, it's not common sense.
Britain is able to afford a pay rise, because let me be clear, Britain deserves a pay rise and Britain is getting a pay rise.
Hospitals are struggling to recruit staff.
But cuts in training places and staff leaving the NHS have left massive gaps.
You're driving us all out of the country, Mr. Hunt. There are people jumping ship every day.
That will bleed the NHS of its junior doctor workforce. That will destroy the NHS.
Unfair, unjust and unsafe contract. And even worse, deceive the public with media spin, misinformation, facts and figures which seem to change almost daily, and scaremongering in order to get away with it.
The secretary said stuff like this.
Jeremy Hunt, doctors must work weekends.
They already do.
Please, now, let's take this down a notch. Let's get the Secretary of State talking again to the junior doctors.
This is the start of the dismantlement of the National Health Service. And as junior doctors, we will strike to prevent this from happening. We cannot let this happen.
The British people will be able to draw their own conclusions when it comes to choosing which party is backing the NHS with the resources it needs, which party is standing four square behind doctors and nurses. And there's only one party that can be trusted, one true party of the NHS, and that is the Conservative Party.